Good morning, my dear students. I'm Sanjana Arora, your English teacher. Today, I've come with a new video on the topic informal letter. Before I start with the explanation of informal letter, I would like to tell you something about what do you mean by letter writing and why there is a need of letter writing. The question might have come in your mind that in this current era of such, you know, booming new technological world, why do we write the letter? We can email the people, we can text a message, we can do so many things. But now with the post, letters, are they actually work or they really need to be posted? Students, I must tell you one thing, that letter writing is still there, of course, although the technology has been upgraded like anything, but letter writing is an actually important concept to be learned by everyone. It should be learned by everyone, in fact, I should say rather. So letter is basically a way, a written way to communicate with the right? So there you can say that if you want to communicate with another person, now you can call, you can tell. But what about the legal processes? What about the written processes? So there the companies, there the judiciary, there the many other like things are actually work on this letter writing only, right? So in this letter writing, we have like different kinds, right? What two different kinds? We have informal letter and formal letter. Formal letter basically is all about when you talk or when you communicate to a person who is not so close to you, or he or she is actually in hierarchical level, or you can say higher in the post, whatever do you say. But yes, this is something that you are not, you can't be that much informal or casual, you have to be formal with the person, so then you write a formal letter. And the second is informal letter. Basically, informal letter is written for like close friends, to the close friends, to relatives, to parents, to your family members, you can say. So in this, I'll going to explain you about the informal letter, how to write an informal letter. I'm going to show you a slide. The first slide is about what do you mean by informal letter. An informal letter or a personal letter is a letter to a close friend. You can say to a close friend, to the close relatives or your cousins or your family members, your parents. So that is called informal letter. The next is about the format of it, how to write it. In your right side, you have to write first your sender's address, like ABC Colony, ABC City. This is your own address. Whosoever is writing the letter, that person has to write their own address. Then after, you have to leave a line and then write the date. Then again leave a line, then write the salutation or super subscription. There you can write the salutation like dear Pooja, dear friend, dear mom, dear dad, like that. Then you may leave a line, one line, and then start writing the, or not even do, you don't have to leave a line, dear Pooja, and then start writing it. Like, I hope you're fine, I hope you're staying in pink health, like that you can start your letter in this. Letter, the body of the letter should be like with the three paragraphs. The first one should be introduction, about the short description, or you may ask the health of the another person to whom you're writing. And then the second is the main content, that why you're writing it. Then the last one is about the conclusion and the end of the letter, by giving regards to your elders and love to your younger ones. And then after, at the last, you simply write yours lovingly and the name. That is called the subscription, including your own name. This is all about the actual format of it. Let's have a look on one example and with some new phrases and the usage of it. The usage means I'm talking about some phrases which you can use in the letter. Let's talk about the next slide, is about the tips. Write your letter on the right hand of your page. Leave one space and write a date beneath your address. Then leave one more space and write the introduction, like dear or something. Writing an introduction, the main body and the conclusion. Then after that, of course, you end the letter either by like with love. Not don't need like that, but simply you can say your lovingly. That would be more enough for you. The next is about the useful phrases. You can use like thank you for your letter. It was nice to hear from you. I'm sorry I haven't written for so long. Hoping to hear from you before too long. I am afraid to say that I won't be able to. Do you think you could? I regret to inform you that we are unable. I'm writing to ask whether is it. Like these are some useful phrases that you can use in your letter writing that too in this informal way. Opening expressions, you can start with even in your email when you're writing to any close friend or someone close to you, or a letter writing that too informal. How are you? How you have been? How's everything going? I hope you're doing fine. Hope you are well. That's new. So you can write like these all phrases or the expressions to open your letter, right? So reason of writing that I'm writing this letter because, the reason I'm writing is because I want to or I would like to. These are the another, you know, way when you need to start the reason that why you're writing this letter. And after that, you can also write that if you want to answer some mail, someone has given you something or like invitation and you need to say no, you can't come. So you can use these all, like thanks for your letter or email. It was great to hear from you. It was so nice to hear about you or from you. Sorry for not writing earlier. I hope you and your family are well. And responding to the news, you may write sorry to hear about, glad to hear about, good luck with, hope you feel better. These are, you know, the expressions which you can use when you need to respond to any of the news which you have got. Like for example, your cousin brother is getting married, so you need to that glad to hear about you that you are getting married. So in that way you can write a letter by using these expressions. In the next slide, I have given you an example how to write it. In this, the question says that you are Spurs Juneja, resident of a student in XYZ school in Bangalore. Write a letter to your mother describing your new school and the hostel life. In the same manner, the way the answer is there, you have to write in the similar way. In this, what you have to see is like the writer's name, the sender's name, the room number, boys hostel XYZ, Bangalore. Leave a line, write the date. Leave a line, dear mom. I'm fine. Hope you with this letter finds in a good health. This is a way again asking the health of the another person. I'm enjoying my new school and hostel life. Though sometimes I feel homesick, but your words of advice always help me overcome the feeling. I believe this school is one of the best that could have gone to. We have the best facilities at our disposal. Being at the playground and the gymnasium or at the lush green lawns. The teachers are very well learned, effective, efficient, and my classmates are helpful. And in this way you can simply write, and furthermore you can describe too. And in the nutshell, in the final one, you can simply say that pay my regards to my dad, to dad, and love to Suhani, and whatever, like any name you can say. And after that, your loving son, and put your name under that. So this way you can write the letter, and I can give you some more assignments also, like in the coming up days, so that you could practice it and it can make it a better way in writing if you'll practice more for this. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope it was worthful for you to understand it also, and even it would be helping you to write the letter in an easy way. Thank you, students, for watching the video. I really love you all. Thank you so much.